999 tonight. We'll take the opening face-off against the Red Wings captain, Dylan Larkin, and here we go. Hockey in Carolina. Coach Ed will wind that puck back into the Detroit corner. Good keeping at the point by Dougie Hamilton. Now across to the slot for Natchez. He scores! Marty Natchez had the empty netter on Thursday and gets the Canes going early in this one. 1-0 on his 11th of the season.
Pitch from Dougie Hamilton here to keep this puck in. Hamilton, our player to watch in the pregame, showing that on the backhand. Trocheck passes it with pace across the ice. They just, I think, didn't know that that pass was coming with the pace that it did when he first received it.
Carolina keeping the pressure on. Good keep in by Gardner. He gets it to Trocheck. Trocheck goes down low, gets a return. He puts one right on. And Grice makes the save on Vincent Trocheck. Aho trying to clear, bothered by Danny DeKeyser. Carolina will get the puck to the point. Not out. Larkin puts one on that Mrazek kicks. Attempt by Stetcher comes through, and now a bouncing puck, and they'll score. Dylan Larkin on a bouncing puck. Was Johnny on the spot, and Detroit has tied this game at one at 13:45 in the first.
Directed this in it all. Nice work from Zadina to establish the shot, and I think Larkin's just going to stop at the net. Now, there is nothing that would represent flexion in that right knee. And perhaps he touches the stick. Zadina.
Puck is put in the corner for the Kane zone.
Oh, you're on tonight.
Trying to, buddy. Now there's Jacob Slavin working it through. Puck doesn't go through. It's deflected, and they'll score. Another bounce out in front. And the Detroit Red Wings have jumped out to a 2-1 lead with 9:50 to go here in the first period.
Below the goal line. And then he just gets to the net first. And you just find a way to get a puck through. On both goals, Biega on the second one.
The assist. Now the Canes are trailing on the scoreboard. Bornell is a spin-around chance by Lorenz. Grice has to make the save. Nice setup by Geeky there. Stepping around the boards. Gets a stick to it. Pokes it back for Larkin. Larkin stopped, and that allows Andrei Svechnikov with speed. He backhands one right on, and Grice makes the save. Think about which way he wants to go with the puck. Plays it off the boards. Martinuk deflects it up for Jordan Staal. He's got a lane. Staal scores! The patented Staal shot. Far post. And the captain ties it in two.
There, Eric scored to beat Brodeur in the dying seconds of Game 7 in 2009. Same spot that he scored to tie the game in Washington in Game 7 a couple years ago. And now that Staal location ties the game.
Carolina looking to clear. Jordan Martinuk does. Just sweeps that out. As we've got a minute 40 left in the first. But now quick up for Mantha. His shot is handled by Mrazek.
Starting with Hamilton and Slavin. Then maybe you'll see Bean along with Brett Pesce.
Puck is one back. Svechnikov gets to it. Now he puts one right on Mrazek. Has the glove and says, I got it. Along the board, Slavin gets to it, but not out. Second attempt, though, will clear the zone. Geeky skates after it, gets it, lays it back at the point. Skating in for the Canes, and shot, they score! Dougie Hamilton! Racing into the zone, Hamilton, sixth of the season, and the Canes take a 3-2 lead.
He starts the play that eventually he finishes, and he takes a look up, and recognize, is this the right time to jump? Am I overpressing? No. His reads have been excellent, and he holds on to the puck for a split second extra. And that's the difference, I think, that Grice isn't quite able to handle it cleanly.
Earlier this period,
puck is kept in and flipped on as Mrazek gloved it, still loose, it slides through his legs, and they score. Mrazek gloved it, but the puck was loose. And it slides between the goaltender's legs and behind him. Seven left here in the second.
May have gone off of Jordan Staal's skate. Boy, our vantage point, I just didn't think this was going to slide underneath Peter. He was not able, obviously, with his glove well in front of him to handle the shot. He swipes it back into harm's way. You know, he's making a decision. You know, at top speed, I don't know why Peter would swipe that back into the middle of the ice. Be great if he could just...
Draw was won by Glendening, but kept in at the point by the Canes. Less than 30 seconds left here in the second period. Cycling behind the net to Aho! A quick pass that was put on.
At each other. I don't think it was friendly banter during the last commercial timeout. The linesman actually had to come over. Love it.
Andre splits it, walks in on Grice, and what a save as Grice. Lorenz takes a shove from Mark Stahl in the corner. Puck out to the point for Gardner. His shot is blocked. And away comes Adam Ernie with speed down the middle, working in, and he scores on the back end. Adam Ernie blocks the shot, goes the distance, and now has given Detroit the lead with 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go here in the third period. It's a 4-3 Red Wings advantage.
For Tampa, he blocks the Gardner shot. Gardner's caught. Bean is trying to recover, and then he very smartly pulls the puck to the backhand to protect it as Bean's trying to go stick on puck. Trying to do the same thing in Detroit, just taking time.
Slavin has it into the Detroit zone on the back end, gets it to the point for... Oh, they score!
Avoiding any contact with the goaltender. Wow, what a play. That's a non-factor. You know, if he's there or not, as long as he's not in the puck's not, or before it gets...
This challenge for goaltender interference, there was contact with the goaltender's skate by Carolina. No goal.
Just at the blue line, works it across to Pesci. Pesci goes down low to Niederreiter. Back to the point for Natchez. He goes across for Aho. Aho looks for an angle. He scores! And this one's not coming off the board. Aho ties it at 4.
Of this group. Niederreiter is part of the play after he had his goal overruled. Utilizes the points, protecting the puck. Beautiful D-to-D pass covering up defensively from Natchez. So his commitment to the two-way game with both defensemen below the tops of the circles, and Aho like Natchez did. Grice for the glove side, so it's a multifaceted impact for both players.
Bring on the three-on-three hockey overtime's underway. And that goes wide, and now the rebound comes out for the Canes. It's the captain, and that's right on. And Grice has to make the save to stick to it, but Evgeny Svechnikov gets to the loose puck. He's fouled along the boards. Hamilton tries to get it. Now it pops free. Shot right on. What a save! Mrazek robbing Hronek with 1:10 left in overtime. Goes over the net, kept in by Hronek. 2 seconds, he fires one. That's going to be absorbed by Aho. And we're going to the shootout.
Oxygen tanks required for Hamilton, Natchez, and Aho.
Comes Dougie Hamilton to start it off for the Hurricanes. In on Grice. Hamilton, head fake, shoulder fake, waits, tries to lift the puck, but Grice makes a left pad save. Here comes Nino Niederreiter. He thought he had the game-tying goal. Can he have the go-ahead marker in the shootout? In on Grice. Niederreiter, oh, dings off the post. Grice might have gotten a pass.
You know, the script the last time Grice was here, what did Williams do? He's shot. I mean, if the Canes get, or sorry, the Canes in reverse retro get it.
Here comes Adam Ernie. Fourth goal of the game here for Detroit. In on Mrazek, goes top corner, and Ernie ends it. And Detroit will get the extra point. Carolina Hurricanes tonight.
History. Steve Yzerman drafted him, and he has had a marvelous year where he has scored more goals than he ever has in just a quick move, backhand, forehand.